Welcome everybody to whatever this is. Everybody here wants you. Jeff Buckley, Young Composer Reacts. Let's go.
Coffee smelling lilac skin, you're flaming me. Twenty-nine pearls in your kiss, a singing smile. Coffee smelling lilac skin, you're flaming me.
Okay, well, yeah. Woo! Jeff Buckley is an American singer, songwriter, guitar player, performer, everything from the 90s, and he tragically died swimming when he was 30. I don't know the year exactly, but it was like 97 maybe, something like that. And he made one big album that was Grace. There's a song from it that you might know, called Hallelujah, originally by Leonard Cohen. But the, you know, it, Hallelujah is really a known song, but the rest of the album is really good as well. And this is actually a song from his album that he was working on when he died, his second album. And I think this was pretty much done, this specific song, but yeah, it's impossible to know for sure. I don't really know. I heard the song already, but I hadn't heard it in a while. And I typically don't listen to music too loud because I have a bit of hearing issues, but I crank it up when I'm trying to react to something, like, safely, you know. But I noticed a lot of things I hadn't noticed. So first off, at the beginning, there's a little fun thing. I wish I could go back. Let's maybe do that, actually. Sounded like a flute, almost like dun, dun, dun. Really cool thing I hadn't ever noticed. Wow, I don't even know where to start with this. Really, the drums are so tight. They're so on point. In the first, I guess I'll start with the unusual stuff. The bass is unusual, very unusual, because it doesn't follow the chords. Typically the bass, especially in pop or rock, it's going to give you a sense of what the chord is by playing the root of the chord. Typically that's what happens. That's why when you play piano, you tend to play the bass with your left hand to give people a sense of what the chord is, because when you, the lowest note that you hear at any moment, that's sort of what you hold on to. And here it keeps playing a E, which is not part of the chord progressions. So the guitars actually play the legit chords, and the bass is sort of like chilling, doing its thing. So what we would call that in terms of music theory is like some chord over E. Here it's a E, I think. Yeah, that keeps playing. Let's just keep listening. Jeff's voice is amazing, but I don't want to ramble.
Such a thing of wonder in this crowd. I'm a stranger in this town. You're free with me. And our eyes locked in outcast love. I sit here proud. Even now you're undressed in your dreams with me. I know it.
Okay, so it keeps building, and that's why I'm interested in doing this, I think, because I've heard this song, like, seriously a good amount of times, but never really focusing on the arrangement, and there's so many things going on. Buckley was a master arranger, and, like, Grace is full of great arrangements to the point of, like, no return. Like, you couldn't possibly add any instrument to this stuff. It's full to the brim. There are slides, guitar slides, like glissandos like that, but with a... I can't find my slide, whatever. There are synth notes, like really scarce throughout the verse. And there's this amazing background vocal that comes in that sounds like a gospel, you know. Flee with me, but like an octave higher. Really cool. There's a shaker that's quite really discreet that comes in during the verse, I believe, and that continues throughout the chorus. And it's already more full than the beginning, and it just doesn't really stop building. So it's sort of drawing the future of the song. And the bass throughout the chorus, it doesn't stay on the E like during the verse. But it actually goes and grabs that higher E, an octave higher or more. And it's sort of walking, but it keeps coming back, though. The anchor of that bass is the lowest note you can play in a standard tuning with the bass.
And all the tears we cried have dried on yesterday. Just a torch to put the flame to all our guilt and shame. And I'll rise like an ember in your name. I know.
Buckley's fucking ridiculous, man. Oh, God. So, we were coming up here on the bridge, and it's funny how your brain remembers this sort of thing. So, I already knew I was going to react to this song today, so sort of the process started yesterday and even the day before. I think listening to Everybody Here Wants You is sort of what made me want to do this whole thing in the first place. The bridge, I remembered it as really scarce, like bass, drums, and one guitar and one voice, that's it. But there's really much more. There's like at least, you know, two guitars going on, one higher up, one down. This is a really good thing to do if you're a guitarist and you're trying to do arrangements. Just like use different shapes. Just, you know, if you play F, play one F chord down the neck, play one up the neck. This is the thing that Tim Pierce, great session guitar player and YouTuber, keeps preaching, which is if you have a part that's one way, make the other one the opposite way. If it's loud, the other has to be quiet. If it's dry, make the other one wet. If it's low, make the other one high. Really works well. And you know, the bridge is not the best part of the song. It's really sort of like just sitting there to give you some fresh return to that original key, right? But it's really much more than just like, you know, power chords and some different lyrics and stuff. Even the simple stuff, Jeff does it well. I mean, this song is really simple. Like the chorus is like three chords, but like the arrangement is amazing. So we keep building, right? As we go back into those verses, etc. We keep building, and then after the... at some point, I'm gonna go back to show you the transition.
Yeah, just a torch to put the flame to all our guilt and shame. And I'll rise like an ember in your name. I know.
See how he's leading in? That's amazing. That's so good. It's like we're coming back from the bridge, right? And we go into this verse and we think, oh, this is just a regular verse. It's not really gonna go anywhere. But he keeps digging in more and more with the voice, right? He's sort of in the same register than he's been throughout the whole song, but he's really going for it now. And then he goes, na na. And you think it's just, you know, sort of a fill, sort of a flow that he's doing in the verse, but he leads it into the chorus when you don't expect it. And there's really not much that's going on throughout this verse because Jeff sort of knows, right, that when he digs in with the voice, you don't need anything else. And suddenly everything's there. And suddenly the bass that's been keeping you on your toes the whole song, fucking edging you, gives in and starts painting and starts outlining the actual chords, and it's beautiful. A special mention to the drums and bass. Those players are amazing. Jeff Buckley live was amazing, by the way. I mean, you know, partially because of those guys. And we have everything here during this intro. We have more synth. We have piano coming in. And we have those repeated, you know, almost like a ghost, repeated licks, that exactly the same one that Jeff uses to go into this last section. And he repeats that. That's the genius of it. He could just use it as a transition to bamboozle all of us, but he keeps just saying it. I can't really say anything else. Just go listen to the song. I think I'm done here. Thank you for watching. Leave a comment for what I should do next, and subscribe to... I'm not gonna... I fell for it. Subscribe to Key of Geebz, because I stole the concept from him. Goodbye.